Whenever you say brain, it is my brain. My brain means me and the world. There is duality, simple. There is me and there is the world. That's it. This is fundamental duality, that I exist as something different from the world. What are the basic characteristics of duality? The two sides of duality appear as opposites. The two sides cannot exist without each other. The two sides are always together. If the world is not there, you cannot be there. Conceive yourself as being worldless. Whenever you are there, the world will be there. So, the two sides of duality are always together. The two sides appear as opposites of each other. So, I am me, and there is the world, which is a stranger, a foreigner, a separate entity. Getting it? Duality is the very stuff of the brain. There is nothing in the brain which is not dual. Every single word will have a dual opposite, otherwise it cannot exist. The entire existence, the entire world inside the brain is dualistic. Pleasure, pain, happiness, sorrow, today, tomorrow, me and you, white and black, here and there. Everything is of a dual nature. This is there only because its opposite exists. If the opposite does not exist, this will not exist. What does this mean? This means that if I am not absolutely stupid, then I will never run after one end of duality. Running after one end of duality is like running after one face of a coin. Running after one face of a coin because you are afraid of the other face. And whenever you get one face of the coin, what do you actually get? That face plus. Plus what? Plus the other face. And what did you want? That face alone. That is not possible. The one running after future will inevitably repeat the past. The one running after pleasure will invariably get pain. The one fond of looking at color black will have to have a white background. This is duality. Implications of this for you are simple. Whenever something appears extremely appealing or very disgusting, whatever, ask yourself that in the process of chasing it or in the process of escaping it, what am I getting? Confidence appears lucrative. I want to be confident. Can there be confidence without fear? If I am not afraid, why will I want to be confident? Why will I want to be confident? None of you sitting over here at this point are confident. Even I am not confident. And why are we not confident? Because we are not afraid. You need confidence only when there is fear. So the wise person never asks for confidence. He says, chasing confidence is a sure shot indicator that I am afraid. Otherwise, why will I want confidence? Confidence and fear are two sides of the same coin, duality. Chasing a job or chasing security and stability in a life is a clear indicator that currently I am hounded by insecurity. So I'm rushing towards security with great speed and energy only because I am so afraid right now. I'm so insecure. So he will never say that security is a wonderful thing. I want somebody in my life. Being young, I need to have a partner. And it's such a pleasurable thing to have or to imagine. But that pleasure arises only from a sense of loneliness. You cannot be too keen about having a partner if you don't keep feeling lonely. If the imagination of a person pleases you, it is just an indication that you keep feeling lonely. That's how duality is present in every aspect of life, in our very day-to-day functioning. Are you getting it? So those who had some sense, they said, it's stupid. Whatever I chase, I get its opposite. In fact, getting the opposite is a fundamental prerequisite for chasing something. If the opposite is not there, that thing cannot be obtained. For happiness to be there, sadness must be there. So they said, this is stupid. I don't want to engage in this game. Let me rather get something which is non-dualistic. Is there something beyond duality? And if there is something beyond duality, only that is worth obtaining. Is there something that does not have an opposite, that does not depend on its opposite? Only that is worth obtaining, because only that is the truth. Because the truth alone does not have an opposite. Everything else has an opposite. So they lived in that way. They said only that is worth getting. Everything else is foolhardy. Rubbish. Yeah?